Hello, my name is Zebra with Zoom, and in this video I will show you our new updated Zoom Life app, and I will show you a couple of the features that this new app has to offer. So before we get started, I want to show you that this right here will be my pointer, so it's easy for you to follow throughout the video. So let's get started. The first thing I want to show you is how to add a device onto your new app. You have the new app now, and now you want to add a new device. So the easiest way to add a device on your new app is via P2P. This is the way that we've always added a device on our apps, and it's the easiest way to add the device. So to get started, we need to go to the top, on the top right hand side, with the plus on the circle here up here. Once we click on that, we need to click under SN/scan. So when you do this for the first time, it is going to request to have access to your camera. Make sure you enable that in order for you to have access to your camera and scan the QR code. So once we click on SN/scan, your camera pops up and you're gonna scan the QR code on your unit. As you can see, our app has recognized our serial number now, and it gives us two options: to add locally or add to account. For the purpose of this video, I will add via a local account. To keep it simple, you will use account when you're adding the new door station to your app. Account does offer a couple more features, which I will later go into detail in a separate video. So once we select local, we need to click next, and here you need to select your device that you're adding. So please pay special attention to the device that you're adding. In this case, I am adding an XVR, so I will click under XVR. Here we need to select our device name. I will just click video, and we need to input our device password. Once we do this, we need to click under save under the top right. Once we save it, as you can see, as easy as that, we have our new device added to our app. So we have a couple new features. The layout does look a bit different on this new app, so I will go over a few of them for you to get a better understanding. So if you would like to make your camera bigger or full screen, you can just double click on it, and you can see now it is full screen. Starting from the left to the right, this icon right here just pauses the video and plays it back up again. This second icon right here, this switches it from substream to mainstream. By default, the app will come set to substream, which is SD. If you click on it, it will switch it to HD, which is mainstream. Just keep in mind that if you do switch it to HD, it will pull a bigger picture. And if you do have slow internet or slow Wi-Fi, it will take a lot longer for the video to load up. So just keep that in mind when you decide to switch it. This third icon right here, this is for you to enable audio. So if your camera comes set with a mic already integrated, or if you added a mic to one of your cameras, this is how you'll be able to listen to the audio from your app. You just have to click on it and you can see you have audio, or shut it off. Here, this icon right here, this is for you to view the view settings. So by default, it comes to 4. You can click on it, switches it to 9. Clicking it one more time, switches it to 16. This icon on the right, this is just for you to flip the phone and get a bigger picture of your cameras. Going back, if we click on this icon right here, this icon just shuts off the video. If you click on it again, it brings everything back up. This icon right here takes a snapshot of whatever camera you're watching. So as you can see, it has a blue highlight on the square. You can see if I move it to a different camera, it puts a little highlight around the square. So whatever highlighted camera it is, if once you click on that, it will take a screenshot of that. If I switch the cameras, it will take a screenshot of that, and so on. So it will just take a screenshot of whatever camera you have selected. And I will later on show you where you can view these screenshots and save them to your camera roll. This icon right here will enable voice. So for example, on our new door station, you can click on this icon right here and you can actually have a conversation with the other person on the side of the doorbell. So just remember, this icon right here is for you to listen to the sound, and this icon right here is for you to enable the voice. This icon right here, this is for you to record a video. So once you click on it, you can see it shows start recording, and on the top left of the camera, you can see there's a little red dot with the amount of seconds that it's been recording. You click on it again, and it stops and it saves the recording. Like I mentioned before, I will show you where you can view these saved snapshots and recording on your app, and how you can also add those files onto your camera roll. This feature right here, this is a new feature that we've added, which it allows you to view playback for a specific camera. So as you can see, the blue highlighted line is specifically for this one. I can click on it and it will show me playback for that camera. If I click on this one, it will do the same thing. On this unit that I've added, currently I do not have a hard drive, so I will go to a separate unit and I will show you that feature. So I will click on this unit down here. You can see I double click this one, I selected it, and if I click on this icon right here, it takes me to playback for that specific camera. So just for you guys to understand, you may be wondering what this is. This is a new feature that we've implemented on the app, which is called picture in picture. What this means is that you can view playback for that specific camera while at the same time viewing the live image of what's currently going on. So this right here, it is live footage of that camera right now. And this right here, it is the playback. So now that we're under playback, you can see that it does look very different from our previous app. On our previous app, it would force you to set up a start time and an end time. On this new app, it does not force you to do that. What it does is that it automatically selects the date that you are. So today is September 9th, 2020, which you can see it shows the date right here. And it starts the recording from today's date at midnight all the way into the current time. So as you can see right now, it is 1:20 and it is showing to be 1 p.m. to where the recording ends. And for you to view playback, all you have to do is with your finger just scroll through this bar. And you can see that you can start viewing playback. So if you want to get more specific to the seconds or the minutes, all you have to do is pinch on this blue square, on this blue timeline. And you can see that it gets specifically to the minutes, or you can pinch out and it will get specifically to the hour. Now going back, you can see that these icons are the same ones from before, snapshot and record. This icon is the same one for you to pause the video. This icon may look a little different. What this icon does is that it speeds up or slows down the video. So once we click on that icon, we have this chart that comes up right here. Times one, if we click on it again, it's times two, times four, and times eight, which is speeding up the playback video. Or we can also slow it down. We click that icon again and we can slow it down. So that's what that icon does. If you do not like the picture in picture, all you can do is you can just click the X. You can move it around. If you just do not like it at all, you can just click the X. And I accidentally clicked the other icon. You can just click the X and it will delete it from there. So that is how you do playback on the actual camera. So if we go back, you can see it's going to take us back to the live footage. Also, that doesn't mean that that's the only way to view playback. If you go back, you can see on the top, we have our regular playback button, which is the same thing as I showed you before. Now, for you to view playback, all you have to do is click on the right-hand side on this icon, select your device that you want to view playback on, select the camera that you want to view playback on, and click Start Playback. And as you can see, it's the exact same way as I showed you earlier. If you do want to change the date, all you have to do is click on here. You can see it pulls up the calendar of the current date that we are on. Currently, we're in September, so it pulls up the calendar of September. And as you can see, on every date, there's a little icon, a little blue record icon. That means that on that date, there is footage available for you to see. So on the 3rd, there's no icon, so that means that whatever footage there was for that day, that footage is now gone, and there is nothing we can do to bring it back. So in case a customer asks, there's nothing we can do to bring that footage back. It has now been overridden, and the recording is lost. So if there's a date that does have the icon, we can just select it and click OK. We can change it to motion recording if you have motion recording enabled, which I will later in a separate video show you how to set up motion recording. If you have smart recording, if you have a smart camera that we now offer, or you can just select all recording or regular recording. And all you have to do is click OK. As you can see, the date down here has now changed, but the process for you to replay back is the same way. So all you have to do is just scroll through the bar. If something happened later on, you can just scroll farther down the road on the bar and it will load up the footage. So that's simple. That is how you can view footage on this new app. So now going back to the homepage, I want to go over a few things here on the homepage. So the first thing I want to show you is the new layout of the homepage. So as you can see, we have this icon up here on the top left. If we click on that on our new app, it allows you to view the screenshots of the cameras that you have available. If you would like, you can click on a specific screenshot and it will load up that specific camera. Or you can click on this all icon, which it will load up all of the cameras that are available for that device. And if you don't like the way this looks, you can just go back and click on the other option that we have available. Now, as you can see, we also have some icons right here, three little dots. This right here is for you to get more settings. So it gives you two options. You can either move the device down, or if you want to move, let's say I want this device to be all the way at the top because it's important to me, I can click on that and I can move it to the top. And as you can see, it puts it on the top of the list. The other option is device details. If we click on device details, you can see it gives me different details. I can change the notification settings. I can enable notifications, the stream settings. I can switch it from subscription to mainstream, remote configurations. If I want to change a couple things here. So it offers a couple features for you to have access and control over your unit. I will go over more of those features in a separate video for it to be more in depth and for you guys to understand a little better how everything works. So now, earlier in the video, I took a couple screenshots and videos. Now I will show you how you can view those pictures. So all you have to do is go to the top, scroll through here, and we need to look for file. Once we click on the file, this is where we have all of our videos and images stored that we've taken on the app. So these images and videos will always stay saved on the app as long as you don't delete the app. If you delete the app, all of the contents that are on the app will be deleted with the app. So make sure you don't delete the app or you will lose everything. Now, if you want to save a certain image to your camera roll, all you have to do is click on this pencil icon right here on the top right. You will select the image that you want to save. In this case, I want to save this one. You can see it highlights it, and all you have to do is click the save icon here in the middle. And you can see that now that image has successfully been saved to your camera roll. Now, if you would like to delete an image, all you have to do is click on this icon again, select an image, and click the trash icon right here. And it will tell you if you want to delete, you delete it. And that is how you delete an image as well. The same way you do it on image, it's the same way you do it on video. You see, you get the same icons. And that is how you view all of your snapshots and image videos that you recorded on your app. So now, last thing I want to show you is, as you can see, I have a lot of units, a lot of devices here on my app. And a problem that you could face when you have a lot of devices is that, for example, on the device called video, I may have a camera that is very important to me. On device called home, I may have a camera that's very important to me. So I don't want to be bouncing from device, you know, view this one and then go back and then view this one and then go back. So what I will show you is how you can add your favorite cameras into one device so you can view them all at the same time and you don't have to be bouncing around. So in order for you to do this, you need to click on all. You let it load. Once you let the image load, you double click on the camera that you want. And what you need to do is you need to click under more functions. Under more functions, you'll see we have some more options that are now enabled. I will go in a separate video which these options do and what they mean. But what we're looking for right now is this little star icon right here. This is the favorites icon. Once we click on that, it's going to allow us to create a favorite device. So what we need to do first is we need to add a device. We're going to put important. We're going to name it important. The file. We're going to click OK. And as you can see, it's collected it successfully. So now that means that this camera has been successfully saved to that file. So if we go back and let's say we want to add another camera. Let's say we want to add this camera right here. All we need to do is click more options. Click the star. And as you can see, we have the file here. It shows the number one because we added a camera already previously. So we're going to click on it again. And now it's added the second camera. Let's go back. And we can add a third camera. Let's see. Let's select this one right here. And let's say we want to add this camera right here. All we need to do is click more functions again. Click the save icon. Click important. and it successfully saved it. Now, for you to view these favorite cameras, this file, all you need to do is go to the homepage, go to favorites at the top, click on favorites, and you can see we have imported, and it shows we have three devices added. All we need to do is click play, and all those three cameras, although they are on different devices, we are viewing them at the same time. So that is a cool feature that we have available as well. If we go back, we can also delete it if we no longer want it. Click OK, and now it's been deleted. So lastly, what I want to go over is the Meep section right here. Well, I'll show you what this means. Under the message tab, this will just show you all the messages that come through. For example, when you set up motion detect or the door station, this is where you'll receive all of your messages. For example, it'll show you motion detection, alert, or stuff like that. And here under me, this is your profile for your app. So on the top, you can see if I click on here, I have my profile. I can change my username, for example, to my name. I'll just put test for now. I'll save it. It will show test. I can add an image and if I would like to. You know, you can personalize your app as you would like to. And right here is also where you set up your account. So earlier, as I showed you, I had, when I was adding the device, it showed me if I wanted to add it locally or via account. This is where you'll be able to set up your account. Like I said, in a separate video, I will show you how to set up an account and what the different features that it has. I just wanted to give you guys an overview of the account portion. Here under general, you can see we have general settings. We can autoplay when not in Wi-Fi, notification settings. Here under period, this is a cool feature that is very helpful that, again, I will go in depth in a separate video for you to understand. Here is the picture in picture that I showed you during playback. You can enable it or enable it if you don't like it. We're going back. And the most important feature that you'll find here is the help feature. So here in the help, it shows you the frequently asked questions of the app. You can have a lot of answers to your questions on this section. But most importantly, you can also have what everything means. So for example, favorites, it shows you what that does. If you go to playback, it shows you what every icon means and what it does and so on. So this is a really, really helpful feature for the app in order for you to better understand the app and what every icon means. So overall, this is a quick overview of our new updated ZUUM Life app. I hope this video helps you out. Thanks for watching.